Well, we have Akinbode Oguntuyi, a basketball analyst on standby, who's going to give us his own view. Also, we have Maka Anyanwu joining us this morning via Skype. Good to have you guys with us.
Yeah, it's a pleasure.
And Maka, well, before we get into it, let me quickly read out the top 10 and I'll share my own sentiments with this now. Now, number one on that list is Michael Jordan. There's also LeBron James, who's on number two position. There's Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on number four. That's on number three. The Bill Russell makes it to number four. Magic Johnson, number five. Wilt Chamberlain, number six. Larry Bird, number seven. Tim Duncan, number eight. Kobe Bryant, the late Kobe Bryant, number nine. And Shaquille O'Neal, number 10. My own sentiment is, why should we place Kobe Bryant in the number nine position? I'll allow Maka to kick off with her analysis.
Okay. For me, I think it's just, I don't know why Kobe is in number nine. First of all, let's talk about him. Love Tim Duncan. There's a lot when you say just time. You have to consider killer instinct. You have to consider, do people fear you? You have to consider 3 seconds left in the game. Who do you give the ball to? You have to consider how they impact their team. And I just don't feel like on any day, I love Tim Duncan. He was great with, you know, Manu Ginobili and Tony Parker. And they had a great, you know, time there in San Antonio. But no, he's not better than Kobe any day. And then you have Larry Bird. I mean, Wilt Chamberlain. Let's talk about Wilt Chamberlain. Like, I mean, he was dominant. I'm one player to actually score 100 points in a game. And, I mean, he dominated, averaging, like, 30 points and 20 rebounds. And I understand, like, he did have a great career. And I'm not taking away from, you know, his accolades and his play. But Kobe Bryant was a force to reckon with. And I think that this list has him way too far down. He needs to, I mean, for me, I would at least put him six or top five. And it has to be like that.
But do you agree with the analysis from Maka saying that Kobe Bryant doesn't deserve to be in the number nine position as well?
Well, you know, the thing about all these all these lists is that most times they are based on the emotions of the group that compile them. Mm. She says she wants Kobe in the top five, but I'm thinking that's probably a generational thing. Because if you watch the guys that are in the top five positions, if you watch them and watch their careers, in fact, there are some players that I feel should be in the top 10 that are not there. For instance, I will argue that, I agree with her that putting Tim Duncan ahead of Kobe and Hakeem Olajuwon, who was listed at 11, I think it's unjust. I know Duncan, I mean, let's be clear, Duncan was the reason I became a San Antonio sports fan. I followed Duncan from college, so I know exactly what Duncan can do. But if you look at Hakeem Olajuwon's career and the impact he had on the game and how Hakeem changed the game, you understand my beef with having Hakeem at 11. But having said that, like I said, I think it's a generational thing. I know there are some people who will argue. That's why I put Jordan ahead of Will. That's why I put Jordan ahead of Kareem at number one position. I have always felt that, look, we all agree Jordan was a great player. But I feel that the arguments around Jordan, they are mostly emotional, as far as I'm concerned, because when you make up all these lists, the odds are that you are going to favor some over others because of how you relate to them or because you have seen their game. And so I think that these lists are pointless. They are just for sports and to generate debates like this. But having said that, I saw Kobe play. I never saw Wilt play. I saw his videos, but I saw Jordan play. I'm still watching LeBron play. And yes, for this generation, Kobe is probably in the top five. Oh. But if you look across the ages, across all the players that have come and gone, look, you I won't be surprised even if some old timers say, "Hey, Kobe, yeah, Kobe was great, but how can I compare Kobe to XYZ?" Put Kobe at 15, and they'll have their reasons. So for me, we can argue all day long. You can generate your own list. I can generate my own, and we'll come up with controversies. So, hey, Kobe at 9, for the group. Maybe it's good for them. For me, I agree with Amaka. Maybe it should be higher, maybe not. But hey, like I said, these are just things that are brought up to generate discussions.
Now, Maka, LeBron James makes it to number two position. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, go on.
I like that thing he talked about generation. That's the thing. If we really look at the older generations, basketball was very different then than it is now. You can compare athleticism. Even the rules were different. The rules then are not the rules today or this generation. So there's a lot of things to actually consider when you're crossing over different generations and level of play. And if you look at also the style of play, I think the style of play, the way basketball is played today, is completely different from Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's era and Michael Jordan's era and so forth. So I think it's really important to look at those specifics when you're considering the best player of all time.
All right, we really do not have much time on our side, but I'll give each of you 30 seconds. Do you think that Michael Jordan was the best NBA player, or would you have given it to Kobe or LeBron James? Body first.
I would give it to Jordan. LeBron James is an amazing player. I mean, he's not done, obviously, but when you cross-reference what they've achieved, he has achieved so much compared to Jordan. But at the end of the day, for me, who do they fear most on the court? You know, who has a presence? Who's more clutch down the stretch? You know, Jordan, he had three consecutive titles once, retired, came back, and three consecutive again. Like, I think that in itself is monumental for the game of basketball. So for me, I would definitely consider Jordan, but LeBron is not too far from where Jordan, you know, where Jordan finished his career. And LeBron has a few more years to go. So I think it'll be very interesting now that he's with the Lakers to see what he can actually achieve and how he can actually finish his career. And then maybe we'll have this conversation again.
All right, thank you guys for talking to me this morning on Basketball Stories. We'll do this again, and I'll have more things to talk about in the world of basketball.